You've clicked Get Data from Folder in Power BI, and suddenly there's a bunch of queries and a mysterious function staring at you. If you've ever ignored it, or worse, poked around and broken things, this video is going to show you exactly what's happening behind the scenes and how to master it so you can customize and control your file imports in ways the default wizard could never do. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. So when you have run Get Data from Folder, this is the kind of stuff that you might have seen. And again, you might have just left it alone, or you might have poked around and broken things. But again, we're going to get inside and show you step by step what each of these mean and how you can leverage this to do more complicated operations when getting files from a folder. So let's look at the download files, and we're going to have here three sets of files. The first one we're going to start with is a really simple example, and that's right there. And then we're going to look at slightly more complicated example. And then also have an advanced example, but we're going to cover that as part of our advanced program. But you will have those files, and you would be able to attempt that problem on your own if you like. But the first two should give you a really good understanding of how the get files from folder works. And by the way, you can always grab our files by going to learnpowerbi.com/download. That's going to give you access to the files being used in this video, as well as our best free resources, including our tutorial and calendar tutorial. All right, so let's get started. So we're going to just jump into transform data, the kitchen of Power BI, Power Query Editor. I think I have this old file. I'm going to delete that. Okay, let's get started. So I'm going to say new source and click more. And in the list, you can choose folder. If you are lost, you can type in folder and find it that way. Or you can click on this file that filters the list to a smaller set. But really, folder is right there. So we're just going to do that and click connect. So let me show you the simple file first. So if you look at this, this is what I call machine-friendly files. And the truth is, I rarely encounter these. But these files are nice and clean, and this is what we're going to start with. And if you go back and I'll show you the other budget example, that gets complicated. It's a little bit different. It is human-friendly, and it's going to create challenges for us when we point to this folder and try to get these files, but we'll solve that step by step. But let's start with the simple folder. And I'm just going to paste the path and hit OK. And in this case, there are some scenarios where you should click transform data. But for this demo, most of the times, I think all the time, we are OK to click combine and transform. But again, even if you click transform data, later on in the steps, you can come back and combine. But now let's just click combine and transform, and it's going to give you that telltale set of functions that we were talking about. So what it does here, it's asking you to select the sample file. Now here's the thing, first file default is usually fine. Now the premise that the get files from folder is based on is that all files are structured alike. But that is where things break down, because again, in real life scenarios, that is rarely the case, and that is what we are here to solve. But in this case, first file is good, and we're going to click the budget and hit OK. And let Power BI do its thing. So again, it's loaded that file. And in this case, it actually gets everything right. But again, this is not a realistic scenario. This is an ideal scenario where everything is clean, the headers are clean, and so forth. Right. So again, maybe this is where you started if you were lucky. And you were like, oh, it just works. But most likely you started in something different. So let's go over to our budget folder. And let me see. Yeah, so this one is a little bit messy. It's got header rows, which we would want to exclude. It's got the data spread across 23 and then 2024 looks similar. But yeah, so let's see how well Power BI handles it. And then we'll step in and fix where things need to be fixed. So again, I'm going to say get data, select folder, click connect, and I'm going to paste the new folder path, hit OK. And again, I'm going to click combine and transform data, but I'm expecting that things would not work so well. So again, first file, and I'm just going to select that, hit OK. All right, now already right away, you can see that there's something going on. It's not quite right. So let's step into the queries. So the simple scenario, we ignored those queries. It just worked. But now let's get in here and let's see what's going on. So we'll walk through step by step. What is the first thing? The parameter. This is just a parameter definition. The key important thing is the second one, which says sample file. Right. So sample file, this is, remember the first dialog box where you said, oh, first file or this file? This is where it takes effect, right? So in this case, since you said first file, what it's doing is if you navigate to the first step, it's going to that folder, getting all the files. And then if you look at the navigation step right there, it's saying source zero, which is essentially saying first file. If you had made a different selection on that dialog box, then you would see that different file. All right, so that's a sample file. We may come back and change it. I think especially with the advanced example, you would have to come back and test a few different things here. Now, the next two are really interesting. So again, so the next two are paired entities. So what's happening here that these two are actually linked together. And Power BI is gonna let you know that they're linked together. So this function, if you click on that, and if you click on Advanced Editor, it's gonna warn you. It's gonna warn you that, hey, this is not like any other functions out there. By the way, functions are an awesome tool in Power Query. And we do cover that in our Power BI Advanced program. You can learn more about that on learnpowerbi.com/advanced. But yeah, functions are amazing, but this one is not like any other function, and that's why it's warning you that, hey, this is attached to another query, which is a really cool way to do it. And I think kudos to Power BI team for implementing it this way. The truth is that even if you step into the advanced editor, even to this day, I try to avoid advanced editor as much as I can, right? So advanced editor would give you kind of the source code, but it's hard to work with. I really enjoy working with the ribbon up here. And that's what it lets you do. Instead of being in the advanced editor and, you know, kind of struggling with M code, whatever transformations you need to make, you can make it right here. And that is our ticket home, my friend. That is where we need to solve this. So again, if you look at this, the first scenario was simple, right? It just needed to go in. Let's look at the simple files again and simply combine those files, right? And all the steps applied to them, simply combine those files. But in this case, before we start combining, so again, we're going to focus on this, and that is going to impact the function, which the function is the one actually being used to compile the file. In fact, if you look at the budget one, right here, look at the steps. That's where it's saying invoke custom function, and it has that function name, transform file to, right? So, but we're not gonna change the function. We're gonna focus from this point on this query, which is associated with the function. All right, so yeah, so I'm glad so now you know this, that's going to really give you superpowers. So when we come in here, so notice what's happening. It's not quite doing it right. In fact, it's kind of a little silly. So we get the data, and as humans, we can see that the headers start here. But, Power BI took its best shot, and it promoted headers. I mean, we don't want this, right? I mean, it did nothing. So we're going to delete this step. So now we're going to take control from Power BI. We'll say, hey, Power BI, thank you so much for all your help to this point. We're going to step in. The humans are in control, right? Okay, so we deleted that step. And then, of course, what we need to do is remove the first three steps. By the way, that is what the advanced challenge that is going to be waiting for you at the end of this video, which you can take on if you download the files. The number of header rows that we need to be removed, or these extra rows, is different for different file. So the 2023 has three, 2024 has four lines, and 2025 has five lines. And, that can happen. In a real scenarios, these are budgets from different years. Maybe the format changed a little bit. How are you going to tackle that automatically in Power BI without hard coding it? Without hard coding, that's the key. Because if you hard code it, if 2026 is slightly different, you're going to have to solve for that. Okay, let's come back here. At least, thankfully, we're in a, this one is straightforward. So we have three rows here. So we're going to simply say remove top rows. So I clicked on remove rows, the arrow next to that, and said remove top rows. And we're going to say three, hit OK, and those top rows are gone. And now we can promote headers. Now we can say use first row as headers from the ribbon up here. And by the way, I have ranted about this in my other videos. We'll see if we can link that in the description. You should always be deleting the change type step. This one, you should always delete it. All right, I said it, there we go. So we're gonna delete it. And then what are we gonna do here? Let's first, so let's do some cleanup. So we're gonna remove, there's subtotal rows in there, right? So you can see kind of the subtotal, grand total. So we're just gonna say category, click on that, text filters does not contain the word total. And mind you, this is case sensitive, so make sure T is capital. Hit okay, those rows are gone, that's great. And then our data is spread across here, and that's not good. Oh, there's a grand total row, and things like this are redundant. They're for humans. Machines don't care because they can compute the grand total. So we remove the grand total, which is good. And now, again, this shape is more human-friendly, not machine-friendly. So we're gonna make it ideal for Power BI by selecting these columns, which is all the columns except the month ones. So category, subcategory, product name, product key, and just don't select any of the month ones, and right-click and say unpivot other columns. I'm not gonna go into this video here, but unpivot other columns is far better than you select these columns, the month columns, and you say unpivot these columns, right? So hope you're getting the difference. So one is like unpivot these columns and one is unpivot these other columns. The short answer is that, I'll save it for another video, but not in all scenarios, but in scenarios like this, unpivot other columns is better. Okay, so we're here, and now, so sometimes I love stepping into the M code. By the way, the formula bar here is a great way to get introduced to the M code. M code isn't scary, it's one of the most friendliest things I've seen. So I love coming in here and just poking around so that I don't have to add an additional step. My queries in real life, often they're extremely long. You know, they're really long because business data is messy, so I'm doing a lot of cleanup and stuff in Power Query. So I like to reduce the number of steps where I can. So here, I'm just gonna get in here and change it here instead of adding a rename step. So this one is month, and the next one is, I'm gonna call it budget amount. So that one is set, and we're good. So we have done it right, but we're not quite home yet, because if you go back to budget, well, gosh, that automatic change type step is messing us up, so ignore that, always delete that. But this one, it looks different, it looks cleaner, but there's still these error rows. Why is that happening? That's a great question. So what we can do is we can come in here and we can see that 2023 is processing just fine. Everything is good. So it's editing out on another file. How do we figure that out? How do we find that out? Well, this is where your other things are gonna come into play. So the sample file, we can change this even after the query. So remember when we pointed out and it asked us to select the first file, but now I wanna test it with budget 2024 and just see what's going on. Why is it editing out? So what I'm gonna do here is go back to source here. And the next step is saying source zero, which is giving me the first row. It's a zero-based index. Source zero is budget 2023, this row, right? I'm gonna say, no, give me the next one. So I'm just gonna go in here and say source one. Now, I'm not gonna hit enter right now because I want you to look carefully here to look at the steps. And something is gonna change and, that was too quick. let's do that again. Okay, so we were at source navigation. I'm gonna change source to one, and notice that it added an extra step. This is not what you want. You don't wanna import the Excel workbook because it wasn't set up that way. So you need to delete this step. But again, now if you notice, we're not working with budget 2023 anymore. We're working with budget 2024. And now that we have changed the sample file, we can go to the transformation query, which is attached to our function, and see what's going on. So if you go here, something is wrong, and we go to error, and it says, oh, it's looking for budget 2023. Oh, that's your clue. I mean, it's looking for that budget 2023. And that is okay. I'm not gonna fault Power BI for that. It's just trying its best, and hey, sometimes it's not as good as us humans, right? Till the AI takes over the world. But if you look at this file, yeah, the sheet name here is budget 2023, and this one has a different name. Power BI based it on the first file, and it's just not working. So that's where we're gonna fix it. So source is looking at the file, and I don't want to hard code budget 2023 or 2024. In this scenario, I just have one sheet. So I'm just going to say, grab the first sheet. Now, of course, if you're connecting to a file where there are multiple sheets, the logic is still going to be similar. However the human is going to figure out, oh, I need that sheet, you need to filter down to that sheet and guide Power BI to that. In our case, our job is simple, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here and remove all of this source item budget 2023 and just say zero, which simply references the first row. So I'm just going to say, you know, get the first sheet. So we'll get the first sheet, and now it's working for 2024. Let's step through promoted headers, filtered rows, removed columns, unpivoted other columns. Everything is working. Now, if you really want, you can test with the third file, but you don't have to, and I would expect it to work now. So I'm going to change it back to zero. Again, remember to remove the step, imported Excel workbook. Otherwise, things are going to break. And now we have the file nice and clean. One last tip for me, that sometimes I'm in here and I'm like, oh my God, this looks so awesome. And I start changing the data type. So month should be a date type, budget amount should be currency, fixed decimal number. But when I go here, it has undone all of that. I'm not really sure why this happens, but the short lesson is for me that don't bother with change type here, just get the data. And then once you have invoked the custom function and expanded all the columns, finally do the change type step. And remember, you're deleting the standard change type step and only adding change type for numbers and dates. So if you went to learnpowerbi.com/download and grab these files, then you would have the advanced files, and another challenge awaits you, which is, how are you gonna solve this problem where the number of rows that need to be removed is different for 23, 24, and 25? That's an interesting challenge that we're gonna solve inside the advanced course. If you wanna learn more about that, then check out learnpowerbi.com/advance. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.